put it out for you?
No, sir.
You think you're better than me? You come to my country, my poor little country, and you think you can be friends with the president?
I'm sorry, sir. Things must have come out wrong. Maybe you can help me. Sorry. Sure. Somewhere between a threatening stare and the soldier's arm to the teeth. John Marston.
My country is banned, John Marston. The rebels have seized the people by the throat and stole away the rebels.
You're no politician, sir.
And I am no soldier, a killer. But we are both beholding to our time. A brave man, perhaps you've heard of him. Coronel Alando. He's trying to preserve the order of our province. To keep our civilization alive. The stuff. The people are confused and usually strange. Sometimes only in service of what is right.
Trying to find a man, an American, an outlaw named Bill Williams. I believe he came here to seek protection from another outlaw named Javier Escuela.
You're no Mormons, but you hunt outlaws?
So it seems. You heard anything of this man?
I am the Gorilla. Or what is left? Outlaws seek each other. They're possibly hiding as thieves and killers, who pose as freedom fighters in the hills of our home. They're united under one traitor name.
Look at that fine-ass race.
If I knew, I would be there, hunting him with everything that is true within me. Play his friends, you.
Like cholera.
Something like that. But it's possible, though. My men are trying to lure him into a trap. Possibly, you could ride with us. And if everything goes okay, I'm sure the Coronel will help you.
Okay.
Vámonos! Are you going to ride with me? cigarettes, an easy place for men to lose himself, whether he wants to get lost or not.
Hopefully not too easy. I ain't got much time to find these men.
There must be a high price on their heads.
The highest price?
And I ask how much?
I'm not getting paid. It's a long story. Being made pay.
I will never understand you Americans.
Me neither.
We have a system of law in Mexico, senor. And we do not tolerate people who take them wrong with their own. However, if you help us, we help you. No one fights for El Allende for long. It's rebellion. It is a disease. It is killing this country.
Don't people have the right to stand up for themselves?
The right? The right? Don't you throw silly ideas at me. What do you know about the rights of the Mexican people?
Very little. Just saying, there must be something behind this rebellion.
I'll tell you what's behind this, Señor Marcio. Lies. Insidious lies. The peasants are stupid, and like gouts, they can be hurting. It only takes a few men to move many.
Maybe they just have enough of being called stupid.
You're talking about things you don't understand.
If you ask me something, I'm gonna give you an answer.
Are you a revolutionary? Is that why you're here?
I was once, I suppose, in a twisted kind of way. Thought I could change something if I fought hard enough.
Change what?
I don't know. Maybe that was the problem.
Revolution is always selfish. It is nothing but greed and ego. Individuals bring their own needs above those of others. It is people fighting for change when they have no idea what change is.
If you're a poor man who's been beat down all his life, any change is gonna seem good.
What? You think overthrowing the government is going to make a poor man rich?
If you're not helping them, it's only natural they're gonna look for someone else who will.
For a tired old revolutionary, you're very naive. What do you want us to do? Walk around giving out money to every poor person in Mexico?
What a terrible idea.
First, they need to look at why they're poor. Then they need to go out and do some work rather than sitting on their culos talking about freedom.
Who's this man we're looking for? The leader of the rebels?
Bram Reyes? He's a traitor, a liar, a coward and a sinner, a hero who has done nothing. I have full no respect for the shit I look this morning, and I ever will for that pathetic war.
That's a nice image.
He is from a rich family, a man born in a golden cradle, who pretends to fight for the poor. He's taking advantage of the ignorant and the weak-minded.
He must be telling the people something they want to hear.
Of course he is. All that bastard does is stand in a balcón giving speeches. It is easy to make promises you can never keep.
It takes more than a few promises to build an army.
It's not far now. Are you ready?
Ready for what?
We will lure the rebels into a trap. There's a train leaving Chaparosa soon. We're going to escort it. They will think it's a supply train. We have no supplies on it.
Very clever.
We must throw the rats out of their holes. Give them some bait they can refuse. Come on, the train is ready. Come on, follow me. There is a train. We must escort it to Casamandela. Come on. Come on.
which pusher later. Oh, you gotta be kidding me. Oh my goodness, you gotta be kidding me. I don't either.